Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll walk you through how to drag and drop the appointments in Blazor Scheduler and how to resize them as well. I'll also explain you how to disable this drag and resize actions programmatically and how to control the scrolling speed while performing drag and resize actions across the edges of Scheduler. You will also learn how easier it is to set the drag or resize interval. And finally, auto navigation between the views while dragging appointments. Now, I will open the existing application where the appointments are already added to the Blazor Scheduler. As we have already explained how to create and configure the Blazor application, as well as how to add the Blazor Scheduler with local or remote data source, so you can refer to the Getting Started video shown in the above YouTube card. And you can also find its reference link in the description part below. Here, to load scheduler with particular date, I have set the property bind selected date with appropriate values. Then, I also define tValue property and assigned appointment data model class to notify scheduler data source type. Along with this, I also set the scheduler height is 500 pixels. Now, let me run this application to show you the output of this example. Look at the scheduler now. By default, you can easily drag and drop the appointments anywhere within the scheduler, as well as you can extend the appointment time by resizing the start or end handlers. Next, I will proceed to show you how to restrict the resizing and dragging action programmatically. To restrict resizing and dragging action, first I need to define the properties allow resizing and allow drag and drop within the schedule code. Then, set its value as false. So here, you can see the scheduler appointments where you cannot resize or drag them because I have disabled these actions programmatically by setting the allow drag and drop and allow resizing options. Now, I am removing these two properties to continue further with the other drag and drop and resizing options. Here, when you drag an appointment to the edges of the scheduler, either to the top or bottom, you can see the scrolling action taking place automatically. Also, you can notice the same when you resize an appointment towards the edges of scheduler. Suppose, if I want can control this scrolling action, then I can follow these ways like, I can modify the scrolling speed, I can delay the scrolling action, or I can even disable the scrolling actions while performing both the dragging and resizing actions. Okay, now I'll proceed to show you the code snippet to achieve this. As a first step, I need to define the schedule events with tValue property. Then, I will define onDragStart and onResizeStart events with its relevant handler functions. Here, I've defined onAppointmentDrag and onAppointmentResize methods, which will receive the arguments of type dragEventsArgs and resizeEventArgs respectively. Now, within this onDragStart event, I am setting the args.scroll.enable value as false. Also, within this onResizeStart event, I am defining the args.scroll.enable value as false. And now, look at the scheduler, while dragging the appointment to the edges, the scrolling action doesn't happen here. In the same way, if I try to resize the appointment towards the edges again, the scrolling action doesn't happen, as these actions has been programmatically controlled within the onDragStart and onResizeStart events. As I said before, you can also control the scrolling speed of an event while performing the drag and resize actions in the scheduler. For this, I may need to set the scroll by option within the onDragStart and onResizeStart events. To control the speed of the scrolling action, I need to set this scroll by option with appropriate value inside these onDragStart and onResizeStart events. And I will comment these enable options to continue further. So here, you can notice, I am dragging the appointment to reach the edge position, but the scrolling actions happens with the provided scroll by value. Similarly, while resizing the appointment to the edges, the scroller reaches the top of the scheduler as soon as the appointment touch the edges of the scheduler. Okay, next I'll show you how to change the drag and resize time interval while dragging or resizing an appointment on scheduler. By default, when I start to drag an appointment, it moves at an interval of 30 minutes. In the same way, when I resize an appointment, you can see it is getting resized at an interval of 30 minutes. Suppose, if I want to change this default 30-minute time interval, then I may need to set the interval option. To change the default time interval within these on drag start and on resize start events, I will define the option interval and set custom values to it. So here, you can see the appointment that is created for a time range from 11 to 12 p.m. And now, when I start to drag it, you can find the start time, changing from 11 to 11:09 a.m. It is dragging at an interval of 9 minutes, as I have set the args.interval as 9. Also, you can notice here, when I resize the appointments, the time interval getting changed from 10:30 to 10:40 a.m. In case if I want to experience the free flow dragging and resizing of appointments, then I can simply set the args.interval value as 1 within this on drag start and on resize start events. Here, you can drag the appointments in a free flow style, as well as you can resize them in a free flow style. Next, let me proceed to show you how to drag an appointment from a date range in the current view to the date that presents in the previous or next view. For example, you can notice the current view displaying the date values between May 2nd and May 8th. If suppose I want to drag this appointment from this current view to the date May 13th, then I need to set the args.navigation.enable option as true within the on drag start event so that auto navigation of views takes place. So now, when I start to drag an appointment and hold it at the left extreme edge for a few seconds, then the view auto navigates to the previous date ranges. And when I drag and hold the appointment at the right extreme edges, then it will move beyond the current date range on the scheduler. Finally, there is another interesting option available on Blazor Scheduler, which allows you to restrict the drag and drop action on specific target areas. For example, if you do not want to drop the appointments on all day cells, then you can exclude those targets to receive the dropped item by mentioning the target selectors to the exclude selectors option of on drag start event. Now, let me show you the code snippet to prevent the drag action. For this, I need to define the args.exclude selectors option and assign it with the class name eAllDayCells. So now, when you try to drop the appointment to the all day row cells, you can notice the appointment not getting dropped onto it. Similarly, you can give multiple target areas here, separated by commas. Now I have added the eWorkCells class name to the exclude selectors, so that you cannot drag and drop this appointment to any of the work cells. Alright, let me summarize some of the important points here. We have seen the different customizable options available on both the drag and resize actions of scheduler events. Also, we have seen how to control the scrolling speed while dragging or resizing an appointment, how to exclude the drag and drop on specific target areas, how to auto-navigate the date ranges while dragging an event. Finally, we have also seen how to set different drag and resize time interval. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link, which is shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting a free license key to use our complete Blazor products if you fit into our community guidelines. So check the link given in the description part to know if you are eligible for using our community license. In my next upcoming video, I'll explain about how to drag and drop an external item into the Blazor scheduler. If you find this video as useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching this video.